very good afternoon from Cardiff. The Arms Park, again, our venue for this afternoon's Under-20s Six Nations Championship. A festival of rugby providing the scaffolding for a bumper day of sport. Today, of course, is the penultimate round of games and the opening act of round four pits second place Ireland against fourth place Italy. There is the rundown of the fixtures. Italy-Ireland getting us underway, followed up by France-Scotland and the hosts Wales facing unbeaten England in the final contest later this evening. There's a look at the table heading into this round. England with the perfect 15 points from 15, three bonus point wins. Italy will look to climb the table and could jump above Ireland in this opening fixture. Ireland look to build pressure on England. It's been a condensed tournament with matches being played in the space of a month, with 6-day turnarounds between fixtures, physically challenging, but a wonderful opportunity. And here are Ireland. Two sides who endured contrasting fortunes last time out. And a few fans here at the Arms Park in Cardiff, bathed in sunshine after morning rain. But the conditions are just about perfect. Of course, the artificial surface. And the venue for all five rounds of this year's championship. Five rounds in 24 days. This, of course, the penultimate round. And here come the Azzurrini. Italy hunting down their top finish in the championship. The best so far in their history is fourth. Today could shape their future as they look to rewrite the history books. Both sides will now join in the acknowledgement that racism is not acceptable in rugby, in sport, or the world we live in.
Rugby is united against racism. We would like to mark our stand against discrimination with a moment of silence.
And we'll now enjoy the anthems of both teams. Wonderful stuff. The Azzurrini arrive for this clash in buoyant mood. A Euro semi-final win for their football team, yes, but also having run in six tries during their thumping 43-3 win over Scotland 6 days ago. Head coach Massimo Brunello expects a sterner test and makes just one change to the starting 15. That comes in the front row where Luca Rizzoli replaces Mirko Spagnolo at loose head prop. Tommaso Menoncello and Filippo Drago swap jerseys in the centres. For Ireland, in contrast, head coach Richie Murphy has freshened things up, ringing the changes for this one with nine alterations from the starting 15 beaten by England. Conor Rankin, Jude Pothelwaite, Ben Carson and Che Mullins all get their first start of the championship in a dangerous looking backline. Captain Alex Kendallin switches to open side with Daniel Okeke coming in for his first start of the championship at eight. Alex Sirocco completes the back row triumvirate. Front row duo Saunderson and De Butler and Lochmarc Morrissey are the other changes to the pack. And a theme throughout this championship, 11 substitutes for each side. The condensed, high-intensity nature of this championship. So both teams well set. A crucial match for both Ireland and Italy as they look to continue to build on solid starts to the championship.
Well, 30 seconds. 30 seconds, Italy. Are you boys ready yet? We'll go off the whistle when it goes. Thank you.
Final thoughts from all of the players. Regenerating the heart rates after the anthems. Our team of officials, led by that man, Scotsman Sam Grove-White, the assistant Simon Mills and John Darcy, and TMO Ian Tempest.
Ireland, stay behind, please, behind the line.
And we're just about there. It's going to be James Humphreys to get us underway, kicking as Ireland play left to right. It's a short kickoff, well gathered by the one change, Luca Rizzoli. As Ireland look to set up field position and build pressure on this Italian side. Here's Humphreys. Osborne, the dangerous Osborne. Here's Doak, clear of the match against Wales. Big fend in the midfield by Pothelwaite. What a way for him to enter the fray.
You're offside, it's charged down by Italy, so you're offside.
No advantage coming. And Sam Grove-White gives the penalty alongside me in the commentary box for this one.
Italy, so
Mike McCarthy, and a very positive start for Ireland.
Yeah, hugely positive start, but they've got to be careful because this Italy side are really not scared to attack from their own 22. We saw it last week against Scotland where they scored within 5 minutes running it from their own 22, scored arguably one of the tries of the tournament running the length. But great field position here for Ireland. An opportunity to kind of really set the tone and get their maul going,
and
something that didn't really function for them against England, and they'll certainly be looking to start big here.
So within 5 metres already, Owen De Butler, the man in possession. Oh, it's a good steal by Italy though. It was Luca Andriani, the skipper intervention,
back on.
Stealing that line out
forward stay,
from
stop.
In front of Harry Sheridan. And Italy once again get the chance to clear their lines. Leonardo Marin, the man on this occasion. Here's Conor Rankin, right-footed step. Good leg drive beyond the initial contact. Doak. There's De Butler. Doak Humphreys. That Ulster duo. Fathers, of course, combined through the 90s for the Ulstermen. It's their sons on this occasion in centre stage though, and here goes Doak.
Mars back here.
Saw the opportunity, but he's been dragged back
just
by
Mark,
Sam Grove-White.
A disappointing set piece start there for Ireland, you know, with the overthrow of the line-out. It's something that functioned really well for them in the first two rounds. I think they had won 22 out of 25 of their line-outs. That didn't function. It wasn't the same statistic for that England game, so certainly an area they need to work on. And the other one is discipline. They gave 19 penalties away against England. You know, if you give them more than 10
Italy.
Penalties away in a game, it's very difficult to win the game. So I'm sure discipline,
again,
set piece and maul defence are areas they've worked on from last week against
again,
England.
Nine.
Richie Murphy has asked his squad to dust themselves down and get ready for more action. That one hits the target. The maul gets going, but Italy looked to have done well to repel the initial charge from Ireland. Here's Sirocco.
Advantage offside four.
Real experienced, gets the ball away. Knew it was a shot to nothing. Penalty on that occasion going against Giacomo Ferrari.
For Italy, never back on making the tackle.
Humphreys again angling for the corner. One of five Ulstermen in this back line for Ireland this afternoon.
Luca, only the ball carrier, no lifter.
Almost an identical position on that 5 metre line from the first line out for Ireland. This time it hits Alex Sirocco right at the top of the jump. Of course, experience with Leinster. The drive comes on. Owen De Butler looks like he's in possession again. Italy pile bodies in, but Ireland are driving forward. De Butler is over. The hooker scores, and Ireland start their afternoon exactly as they would have wanted to.
Yeah, and it's been a really bright start for Ireland. They've had all the pressure, all the field position. They've had a couple of goes at the maul, exerting their pressure. First one was an overthrow. Second one, they got that go forward. I felt a little bit unlucky not to get the penalty for Italy, pulling it down. But you see here, Sirocco, he's great. He scored off a line-out last week against England. Wins the ball here. They peel round. Everyone facing forward. Good body positions. They keep together, and Owen De Butler gets over. And he's been really good with the missing Ronan Loughnan and with Lee Barron and Tom Stewart missing. They're a bit light in that position. And that's a great start by Owen De Butler.
First opportunity for Nathan Doak. 20 points and player of the match versus Wales. He's started his run-up, so he's under pressure. Unfortunate. Just the breeze here at Cardiff Arms Park, taking the ball off the tee. But Ireland have the start that Richie Murphy has asked of them. The reaction after the English loss, and 5 points to show for it, Mike.
Exactly, yeah, and there's that man in there as well, Daniel Okeke, his first start of the campaign. I'm really looking forward to seeing him. I heard Richie Murphy saying he runs 100 metres in under 12 seconds, and 113 kgs, I'm looking forward to seeing that.
That's just like you. You of old, Mike, I'm sure.
Back in the day, eh?
Here's Doak onto his left foot, chooses a spiral, and fantastic outcome, building that score with a solid exit. Exactly what you're looking for in that scenario, Mike. So often the case, coaches say the points only really count when you exit off the next set piece.
Exactly, certainly one of the coaches' pet hates, you know, you score a try, you score points, whatever it is, you come back and you receive the kickoff and you don't exit properly. So that's a really good exit, really releases the pressure, and you know, they've got good field position and they've just stolen it as well.
Mark Morrissey, the beneficiary, bedlam in that Italian line-out in the early stages. Here is Okeke. You can't miss him, he is a big physical specimen. Little charge down, it's on here. It is on here, and Jay-Z, we've seen this pace, we've seen the danger, he pulls it, and Jay-Z is over. Stretches out the left arm. Italy capitalise on a charge down. And you go a long way to find a player in this junior under 26 Nations Championship. You would want that ball to bounce with, and Simone Jay-Z makes it count. Opportunistic. What a finish.
What a finish. Charge down there of the kick, putting pressure on. That's something they brought last week. Real line speed in the defence. James Humphreys gets the kick charge down. But their back three, Italy's back three, are electric. And Simone Jay-Z absolutely flying down that wing. And what a finish. They score unbelievable tries. We saw it last week. Six tries against Scotland. We just mentioned it. They run from their own 22. And, you know, Ireland have got to be so careful off turnover ball. That back three is absolutely electric. And that is a great finish.
The back three are three sticks of dynamite. They are all wonderful finishers, incredible runners, and we've just seen it there. First actual possession, really, for Italy. It came from a charge down. The good work done by Lorenzo Cannone, but it certainly still took some finishing. And here's Leonardo Marin the opportunity to give Italy the lead. It is blustery. You'll see there the ball flight just drifting out right, but Italy balanced the books, and here's that charge down again.
Yeah, a little bit of a nervy start for Humphries there. You know, he's just back after round one after getting that facial injury. And this Italy back three, we said it, they're potent, they're dangerous, they're electric. And this Italy side, they're not scared to push the offload.
So we thought we'd have a contest coming into this. A big shot coming in there from Jude Pothelwaite.
Ball wasn't out, it was still in.
Couple of really physical impacts, both sides of the ball by Pothelwaite in the opening exchanges. He's a big man, highly rated in Northern Ireland and Ireland in general, the Ulsterman.
Ball got out.
Yeah, and this obviously been his full debut. He's been off the bench the first three rounds. So guys really getting a chance. He said it there at the start, nine changes to the starting team, new combinations. Individuals a chance to impress.
I think they might be having a look at the TMO here. From the kickoff, the Jude Pothelwaite collision, I think. Ian Tempest is our TMO. We're going to have a look at this again.
It's great in the TMO. Maybe. Do we need to formalise this tempo?
Yes, please, Sam. Yep. Needs to formalise this.
TMO check. Just wait till it's green. We'll have a look.
We're looking at the tackle by 13 green, mate. Okay. Tackle by 13 green.
Right, we're at the screen now, mate, so.
It's coming now, mate. Perfect. Coming now.
Just can you just give us some time, please?
So, Mike, it looks like it's Jude Pothelwaite on Ross Vincent, the
tempo,
the open side. Straight from the kickoff. What are your initial thoughts on this?
Contact here, mate.
The initial thoughts looks definitely high to me.
Do you want me to freeze it, point of contact, mate?
Yes, please. Let's freeze it, point of contact.
Letter of the law at the moment, that's high. There was a similar one last week against England, Ireland versus England.
We've frozen at the point of contact. There is shoulder contact to the head and neck area there, isn't there?
I'm rolling it through, mate, so yes, there is for me. So there you go there, mate.
So I agree, there is contact there in the neck here. The Italian player is ducking down, though. So that's a clear line of mitigation there. Do you agree with that, Millsy, Tempo?
Yeah, we're going to get that angle, mate, so we can see that clearly for you.
Yeah, no worries, mate.
So here's the dip, mate. If you're looking at his right knee, there is a dip there.
There is a dip. Look, the Irish player is trying to make a legitimate tackle, I think.
Yeah.
Then we should look at the force here. Is it low force? Is it high force? I'm probably seeing this as lower force. Would you agree?
Yeah, real speed, please, director. Real speed coming now, mate.
Like, the sort of medium force there. He has ducked into it, mitigating that down. So I think we're going yellow card for this.
Yeah, I agree, mate. Yellow card.
Number of that player is?
Number 13.
Number 13. Can you just guide me to the mark, please? 13 Ireland, please. Yeah.
So, Mike, again, following the protocol, we're going to hear Sam Grove-White's explanation
here to
Jude Pothelwaite, and then we'll dissect it.
You have made contact ahead. He is ducked. It's a yellow card offence. Italy. Luca, the penalty is on the same mark. You have kicked.
So, reflections on that, Mike?
Yeah, I think that's fair. I think it's bang on. You know, it was a high tackle. And what are the referees looking for? Is the player attempting to make a legal tackle? Yes, he was. Is he bent at the hips, attempting to wrap the arms? Then a drop in height is used as mitigation. Clearly, you know, he was coming downwards there. So, you know, a fair decision. And Jude Pothelwaite, you know, looking to make a legitimate tackle there.
So, Italy, a man in the ascendancy for the next 10 minutes. That yellow card coming for Jude Pothelwaite. Here's a carry on the man who took the impact. Ross Vincent, great to see him back on his feet. The man from the Ivan Franciscato National Academy.
You're off feet first, then you've stolen the ball.
Another breakdown penalty.
You're off feet, not supporting body weight, then you've stolen the ball.
And just going back to that Jude Pothelwaite tackle, I think, as we said, it's his full debut. He's been off the bench the first three rounds. And, you know, when you've got that frustration that you're not starting, sometimes, you know, you come into the game, you really want to exert that physicality and bring a real energy. And it can, sometimes it can be quite hard balance to get that exactly right in terms of, you know, being disciplined, but bringing that physicality as well.
I think they got to the right decision, Mike. I agree with you. I think the dip in the head in the height of Ross Vincent meant that the shot ended up higher than it might have done otherwise from Pothelwaite. So,
90 out.
Italy have the field position now. Alex Kendall in the skipper, off his feet and handling in the ruck. So here they go. Target hit by Tommaso Di Bartolomeo.
First off.
The hooker now in possession at the back of the mall.
Don't change that.
The work done at the front by the forwards, just creeping their way into the Irish 22. Has Sirocco got through on that? The ball looks like it's on the ground. Penalty advantage going Italy's way. Sam Grove White deemed Sirocco to have been legal, but collapsing them all. Throws his hands up, apologises. That's a head of hair to make you jealous, isn't it, Alex Sirocco's?
Yeah, it's beautiful. I said last week I called him Rambo. But listen, he's done really well there, Sirocco. He's come through the middle, totally legal. He's got his hands on the ball, and you used to be able to get away with dropping it straight to the floor, but you can't do that now. You know, if you swim through the middle, you get your hands on the ball, you can't drop it onto the floor. It's got to come down naturally. So that's why he's been penalised.
Vincent,
early.
This man, this time the target man. Penalty advantage again for Italy. Di Bartolomeo, the man at the back.
First off.
Manfredi Albanese adds his 75 kilograms. Here go Italy out to the midfield. Oh, that pass almost went to hand. It was Menoncello who saw the gap. The pass was just behind him from Leonardo Marin.
Taken underneath.
But the opportunity was there, Mike.
Down. I will speak about them delaying, okay?
Yeah,
early
look.
Hit.
It was a lovely line.
You cannot delay them up, okay? They must come up and down.
Okay.
Understand?
Yeah.
Thank you.
It was a lovely line, and that space has come for the backs off the momentum from that maul. It's drawing in so many defenders that it's creating space out wide. And this is an area that Ireland did struggle against England last week. I think they conceded 3 maul tries, something Italy certainly will have looked at, done their homework, and you know they'll certainly be looking to get that same traction that England got against Ireland. On the flip side, Ireland will be certainly looking to change up how they defend this.
Piantella this time, the Benetton lock, gets this maul going. Di Bartolomeo is there. As backs pile in, it's Jay-Z, the initial try scorer. Jay-Z adds his weight. And for all money, it looks like Italy are over. Tommaso Di Bartolomeo looks to have come up with the ball, slam dunks it onto the ground, but there he is. We saw De Butler get one from an Irish mall. This time is Di Bartolomeo, the beneficiary of all the work done in front. And Italy take the lead and capitalise on that one-man advantage.
Yeah, similar to Ireland, Italy have had a few chances to exert their pressure in the mall. And, you know, third time lucky, they get over. It's a really well-worked try. I'd like to see a bit more aggression and venom in the Irish defence. And as soon as that ball winner, his feet touch the floor, you've got to hit it with serious force and momentum back towards the touchline. So a little bit placid there in the way the Irish defended. And, you know, really well-worked from Italy. You know, they're tight. Low body positions. Tommaso Di Bartolomeo getting over.
Leonardo Marin has taken this ball quite a distance back. He's 25 metres from the goal line on the angle. It is breezy. We saw that in his first opportunity. This one's slightly easier. Clean strike, but just left of the left-hand post. Italy have their second try. They can't make it 7 points. But here again, the maul, the impact of that maul. and rewarded.
Yeah, and as we mentioned, Ireland with nine changes in a short space of time, you know, 5-6 day turnaround, it's very difficult to get those combinations and everyone on the same page. So something as technical as defending them all, it's not just pushing, there's actually a lot of intricacies into defending them all. You know, that can be quite difficult.
But it's an error from the kickoff by Lorenzo Cannoni. Offers Ireland an immediate opportunity to hit back. Sam Illo with the carry. Here's Okeke. Round the corner, there's Okeke, I beg your pardon. Doak at the base on this occasion. Ireland within 5 metres. Ben Carson knocked back. Soroka picks and passes. And it's all about the close stuff now. Here's Illo, his penalty advantage coming for Ireland. Another couple of inches made. De Butler, the first try scorer of the afternoon. Sirocco, that flash of brown hair. Pick and go from the base. There are bodies everywhere. Saunderson is over. And Ireland hit back immediately and level things up. George Saunderson, the man with the pick and go. And Ireland are level, balancing the books.
Yeah, lovely response from Ireland. Comes off, you know, a drop kickoff. We spoke about, you know, the coach's pet hate of kickoffs. You know, they lose the ball there, but it's great continuity and showing their pick-and-go game, which we didn't really get a chance to see much of last week against England, but it is very effective. You know, they get the ball carrier with two latches either side of the ball carrier, driving them through the contact. And that's good work from George Saunderson.
Doak adds the two. Ireland up the lead back. But it's just the big beast rode the tackle of Luca Rizzioli and fought beyond the tackle to get over the line. Richie Murphy will be delighted with the reaction. It did come from that error from Lorenzo Cannoni. Looked like he had lost track of the ball in the sunlight. It is beaming sunshine, as you can see here at Cardiff Arms Park. Nathan Doak, not quite with the clearance he was looking for off the left foot.
Yeah, and that's from Flavio Vaccari's pressure. Absolutely flying up, trying to put the kicker in under as much pressure as possible. And that's a good result for Italy.
I agree. Italy, let's have it.
He's been really good, Vaccari, over the first number of rounds. Mentioned that try he scored last week against Scotland within 5 minutes.
Well, it's been anything but predictable so far. Here's De Bartolomeo, the try scorer, pick collision in midfield on Filippo Drago. Quick hands. Oh, and he's straight through. Leonardo Marin from nowhere pierces his way through the Irish defence. Italy respond within seconds. And it's a thundering carry from that man. Leonardo Marin with a try, and Italy have their third.
Wow, we've got an absolute try fest here. Five tries within 18 minutes.
Italy.
Yeah, it's a pretty poor exit from Ireland, and that's poor missed tackle. Leonardo Marin really doesn't have to work too hard to make that break. Yes, he's quick, he's fast. And they do back themselves, they back their skills, they go at the line, they go hard, but that is just a one-on-one missed tackle.
Was someone speaking as that line out?
James Humphreys, the man to miss that tackle. Marine with the outside break, expertly finished.
And for James Humphreys, yes, it's a missed tackle, but you know, they are pretty narrow in their defence there, so it's leaving James Humphreys a lot of work to do to make that tackle. But as we said, that continuity with nine changes, it can be difficult in all facets of the game.
Richie Murphy in his coaching box there will be very disappointed to have conceded so soon after scoring themselves. Five tries already in the opening quarter. Anything but predictable.
the beauty of this under 20s Six Nations Championship. Marin, similar position to his first conversion attempt. He will be getting to grips with the breeze now. That one's much cleaner strike. Straight down the middle. Marin makes 5-7. Italy back in the lead.
Yeah, and Italy with a pretty subtle team, not too many changes for them, as opposed to Ireland's nine. So perhaps we're, you know, that's what we're seeing. More of a togetherness from this Italy side.
Flavio Vaccari with his first touch. He scored arguably the try of the championship so far against Scotland, coast to coast, from down in this right-hand corner.
Stay on.
Three or four offloads out the back door, and the Gazelle strode in from 50 metres. This time, though, it's just the basics. Set up the platform for Manfredi Albanese to clear his lines. And he does so very, very tidily.
As a scrum half, Roy, that's a textbook exit, isn't it? For Manfredo Albanese. Absolutely perfect.
Everything that was right with that was wrong with the previous kickoff receipt from Italy, that's for sure. There we go. Jude Puthelwaite back on after his 10 minutes on the naughty step. Here's Humphreys, looks for that chip that he looked for earlier. It's the same result. It's a charge down from Marin. Marin with a gorgeous offload. And Jay-Z with the fend. That dangerous fend. Tried to get the ball away there to Manfredi Albanese. My goodness, Simone Jay-Z once again was millimetres away from getting away for his second try.
They're so dangerous, aren't they? It's incredible. Out of nothing, another charge down
in
by on Humphreys.
Last time, Ed.
Same pictures we saw before. And once they get the ball, they are incredibly fast.
It's a great grab by Nicola Piantella. Fingertip catch on that line-out. Here's Rizzoli into that midfield with Filippo Drago. Quick ball again, Marin into that outside channel. Pani this time. We spoke about the danger of the back three. Pani, the third one of that back three triumvirate. All of them with jet shoes, bringing different skill sets across the board. Advantage coming for Italy.
That's fine.
Not on this occasion. Alex Kendallin over the top, nicking that one.
Green, never on.
Ben Carson deemed to have never been onside in that midfield. What do you do here, Mike? Corner?
I think back, based on their last maul where they got good go forward. They've got them under the pump here. They've certainly got them in a pressure position. They're certainly going to back themselves and go for that maul again where they got so much success off the last time.
Nothing early, Ireland.
So this charge down from Ireland possession now sees Italy within 5 metres again. Discipline at the breakdown, a problem for both sides when without the ball.
Holding the man in the air.
They were warned, weren't they? Initially with that line out previously, Ross Vincent deemed to have been held up. They were warned, and on this occasion, Sam Grove-White comes down on them.
Free kick, holding the man in the air.
Yeah, and with that, it's, you know, teams try that every now and again. Normally teams have a call to try and execute that, where you keep the jumper in the air as he catches the ball for that split second, and it forces the opposition to hit the maul early. They normally get pinged for it.
It's an error in the clearance, though, by Ireland.
Ireland forward, keep coming.
Jamie Osborne puts it onto his big left foot and makes sure that this occasion he finds the touch. He's started all four games so far in the championship. One of the more experienced members of this Ireland squad, of course. Mike, you alluded to it.
Okay?
A handful of players now either haven't come into the championship or have been injured during the championships. So Richie Murphy having to really test his squad depth.
Yeah, exactly. And they've had to fly two players out this week as well to add to their squad. They're not involved today. But yeah, they've lost some bodies, you know, when you think they haven't played for 15, 16 months and then they're into this compact schedule. Injuries are always going to happen.
Yeah, certainly a shock to the system for many of the players. Of course, a number of them do have Pro 14 or Rainbow Cup experience for some of the sides in Ireland or Italy or Scotland or Wales. Many Premiership players in that England under 20 squad as well. But for the rest, this under 26 nations has been the first competitive action.
It's going to be their ball. Yeah.
For up to 16 months.
Yeah, I agree.
Incredibly challenging time. Many of them first action from school, and you're thrust into proper senior, albeit still age group rugby, but it's a big jump from under 18s to under 20s, isn't it, Mike?
Yeah, exactly, and it's a very compact schedule, as we know. Number of games with 5-6 day breaks. You know, the longer the tournament goes on, the more impact that has on the individuals in terms of their recovery and being fully fit and fresh going into games.
And of course, COVID bubbles, which are grabbing the news every single day. These players in their hotels for the duration. Strong defence.
We'll go back.
By Italy, but Sam Grove-White's going to come back across for penalty advantage. Discipline for both sides, Mike. A little bit of an issue so far in this match.
Yeah, and for Ireland, that's five penalties conceded already. Touched on it earlier. They gave away 19 penalties against England, and that's, you know, that was partly due to the pressure they were under from a, you know, a bigger, heavier pack. But you know, five penalties. And they want to be careful. Stay on the right side of the referee.
Penalty there. Maul was formed and dragged down by Italy. We'll see some big collisions right across the field. That one there, Lorenzo Cannoni, the Italian number 8. Younger brother of Nicolo, the under 20 international. Former under 20 international, now of course Italian international.
Don't change.
He's a chip off the old block, but this time Ireland build the Maul. The pressure comes on into the Italian 22. It's the Butler, the try scorer, in possession. Ball now being transferred back. Bodies everywhere. Ireland deemed to go to ground by Sam Grove-White. Still in possession. De Bartolomeo, though, wins his side a penalty over the top of skipper Alex Kendallin. And a precious turnover there, Mike.
Yeah, it was a really well-worked maul from Ireland. They threw to the tail. Perfect throw, perfect jump. Soroka won it, came down. They got fantastic go forward off that maul. It was looking really good. And unfortunately for Ireland, Alex Kendallin just gets turned over.
If there was a no-arm tackle, the TMO will let me know about it, OK? Back we go, Ted. Thank you. Are you good?
Here's some possession stats, Mike. We see the dominance of Italy so far in this first half. Of course, the 10 minutes Ireland had to do without the ball. But Italy, you'd certainly argue, deserve the narrow lead they have.
Are you good?
Oh, 100%. But I think I have to say that...
Time on, please. Water off.
A lot of it has come from Ireland's own mistakes. You know, charge down of kicks, missing touch, etc. Those unforced errors, which are giving Italy that field position, and then we know how dangerous they are off counter-attack. Off any mistakes, they want to run the ball, they want to attack you. But we spoke about Italy's performance last week, where they scored 6 tries against Scotland, but it wasn't just their attack. Scotland didn't score a try. They brought a real blitz defence, a real aggression and hunger to get off the line and give the ball carrier as little time on the ball as possible.
And this production line of young players coming through the Azzurrini to supply the senior Italian game. And here they are on the move. That left foot nudged through from Lorenzo Pani, chased down by the man Jay-Z in the headgear. Tried the tap tackle. Che Mullins, big afternoon for that young man. Debut off the bench against England, his first start for the Bristol Bears Academy player. There's a clearance on the right foot this time by Nathan Doak. Comfortable off both feet. Real talent, Doak, the Ulsterman. Here's De Bartolomeo. Saw the opportunity to tip it on Giacomo Ferrari with the carry. Here's Marine onto the outside channel. Look for this man, Vaccari. Vaccari chips and goes. Can he regather? Runs backwards. I think it was from Humphreys. Oh, in fact, it was Jamie Osborne getting his fingertips to it. Vaccari, the pass might have been all on the inside. To his teammate in support. Chose the chip, didn't come off on this occasion, but the pressure is still there.
Forward stay.
Osborne. Again with that howitzer of a left boot, this time clears his lines, but again, Mike, we're seeing the danger that this Italian side pose and their ability to get the ball into the outside channels.
Time off.
Yeah, and we saw Flavio Vaccari there with a little chip over the top, you know, just shows the confidence he's playing with at the moment. It wasn't a bad chip, doesn't manage to regather it, but, you know, we said this back three, they're electric. But that space was created from Ireland biting in the defence. Got to be careful, you've got to make that tackle. If you're coming in, try and hit the man with the ball, you have to make the tackle. If you don't, it creates that space out wide.
Okay? So there's the table as it stands. We'll get updates throughout the day.
Time for battle one, so yeah.
Italy, of course, desperate to climb this table. Ireland look to keep the pressure on.
We'll get the line set.
Unbeaten England. There's plenty of rugby left in this under 20s Six Nations Championship. Of course, this is the penultimate round. The final round of games next Tuesday back at Cardiff Arms Park. There's Massimo Brunello. He played for the senior Azzurri team back in the late 80s, early 90s. Albanese. Lorenzo Cannoni, his third start of the championship. Albanese again. Jon Nicolai, two tries for the tight head prop. So far in the championship.
Again.
Some close range thud and blunder from Italy. Albanese, good, beautiful line, well taken by Vincent. Couldn't get the offload away, but it's quick ball again. Here's Marine, lovely angle from Pani. Couldn't quite gather it. The intent was there. The speed of ball was there. And as if you were in any doubt, Italy are here to play.
Most definitely, and that was a lovely line from Ross Vincent. Did really well to actually keep hold of the ball because it was a little bit behind him. And Pani with a lovely line as well. They were building very nicely, but just couldn't keep hold of the ball. Look at this, everyone in motion, everyone a threat. See that pass behind him, does really well to hang on to that. A good fend there. Gets down, good clear out of the breakdown, and, you know, they are building pressure. They look very dangerous.
Alex Kendlin, the Irish skipper, did well there, didn't he? Managed to get his opposite man, Vincent, to deck.
Water off, please.
Yeah, and he's had a great tournament. The player of the match, round one against Scotland. His work rate.
So, fellas, first scrum, we've come this far. Balance, nothing early, OK? Listen to the calls.
First scrum of the afternoon, Mike. Is that why we've had such a good game? 31st minute of the match, and we have our first scrum.
Balance, patience.
Key messages coming through from Sam Grove-White. Five. Balance and patience. Let's see if the front rows listen.
Five. Six.
Italian scrum, build pressure. Do they have it? Oh no. Well gathered at the back from Kendallin, but
the ball was
there to be won.
Ball was out.
And it's penalty for the Azzurrini.
Seven, that's the last time you come at me after a penalty, okay?
And immediately Luca Andriani steps forward and points at the sticks, looking to stretch this lead, Mike, but real pressure coming through this scrum.
Yeah, real pressure. Yep. And again, it's that togetherness. Italy scrumming as one, all eight of them scrumming as one. Looks like Ireland kind of like in their own little individual battles. And first scrum of the game, both teams want to paint that picture to the referee that they're dominant scrum. And clearly there, Italy getting the nudge, getting the go forward. And, you know, for Ireland, they are down four props, unfortunately, that toll of injuries throughout the tournament. So new personnel in, but that's a great scrum by Italy.
It's Leonardo Marin try and a conversion so far this afternoon. One from three off the tee. This one crucial. Could well be crucial come the end of this match. It will stretch the lead, of course, to beyond the one score. A couple of deep breaths, composes himself. Creeps up on the ball and strikes it through the middle.
And I think the way Ireland want to play, it depends on that strong set piece, parity or dominance. And, you know, they had that in the first two rounds. They had that against Scotland. They had that against Wales. And as a result, they scored a lot of tries. Ireland they didn't have it against England. And Italy getting the upper hand so far with 33 minutes gone.
Surely this young Italian side will have been inspired by the footballers last night. Mike, you'd imagine they would have been in their Cardiff hotel.
Penalties kept me up late, past my bedtime anyway.
Well beyond my bedtime as well.
Stop in front. Advantage, all advancing.
Advantage being played for Ireland.
We're going to go back to the penalty. Three is the number I got, but everyone that was beside three was advancing.
So Jan Nicolai of the Cavalieri Prato Club, there he is, in shot.
Yeah. Three is the number, but everyone that was here.
Three was the number, but I think everybody advancing in front of the kicker. It's a law that's really come into play, hasn't it, Mike, with regards to trying to create space on field and this really being refereed. You see, the kick goes in there, nobody's gone beyond it.
On the line.
And there are those bodies advancing upfield. And Ireland, Luca, I think for the third time in this half, have the opportunity. 5 metre line out, identical spot. Last time they were here, it was Owen de Butler, the try scorer. His second of the championship try against England last time out but that one's not straight.
Not straight.
An opportunity goes.
Not straight,
the Butler curses
arm.
Himself.
Not straight, outside arm. Look at option. Strong.
That's always going to be one that frustrates, Mike.
Yeah, hugely. You've got to take these opportunities when they come up. You just have to. They don't come around that often, so you've got to really go for them. Harry Sheridan, you know, looked, the movement looked really good. Got up in the air, but just not straight.
Balance.
So perhaps the next one, they'll just simplify it as much as possible. Minimal movement in the lineout and just get the ball in and win it.
Set.
So our second scrum of the afternoon. Italy just nudged themselves forward.
Right, use that now.
Now told to use it. And it's Cannoni just eyes up James Humphreys. You mentioned it, Mike, returning from a facial injury against Scotland. And that's not what you want to see coming towards you. He was helped out by Ben Carson.
Use it!
But that was route one. Lorenzo Cannoni gives Manfredi Albanese the platform and he clears, but it's not gone out of play. Osborne in field. There is that man, Humphreys. Little dink through, goes to nobody from Conor Rankin. Look out, Italy on the charge. Oh, free flowing. Menoncello pins his ears back. Offload knocked on by the skipper Andriani. It's Harum Scarum. Doak has enough. Shows and goes. Drago.
Holy.
Caught in that tackle area. Curses himself. Holy. But Ireland need to be careful, Mike, to give that ball away as easy as that.
Exactly, and that's about the third or fourth time they've tried to, Ireland have tried to kick, and it's, you know, they've lost the ball. And from that, Italy are playing against an unstructured defence that's not ready to defend, and Italy are getting a lot of traction from it. Menoncello showing how dangerous he is there. Lovely weaving run. Probably throws a bit of a speculative offload there. But I'd love to see someone else making this tackle. Yeah, you don't, ideally don't want your fly half tackling a number eight with a 10-metre run-up.
I'm sure James Humphreys echoes that one, Mike. I'm sure he'd like to see someone else giving him a hand as well. You just saw the fury in Lorenzo Cannoni's eyes.
Off you go.
Yeah, and it's good to see James Humphreys back, you know, looking to follow on from his dad's footsteps. David,
time off.
Ulster legend, 163 games for Ulster, 72 Irish caps. And yeah, David, James Humphreys spoke about going to see his dad play on Friday nights at Raven Hill when he was growing up. So I'm sure he gets lots of good advice from his dad.
Well, that Doak Humphreys halfback combination, there are some of the stats there. Italy, more carries. Look at those metres made. Almost 300 metres so far in this half. Three times the Ireland metres made on those three line breaks. Showing rear danger with ball. But let's come back to the Doak Humphreys combination. Mike, doesn't it make you feel old when you're commentating on the sons of men that we would have grown up?
Ireland good.
Well, certainly I played against Neil Doak and David Humphreys in their sort of latter years, I would say, at Ulster Rugby, and now it's over to their sons to do the job.
Yeah, exactly. I don't know if I think the fact of the matter is we are old.
That's going to be Rory, here. So, Ireland in form and then up in title.
Yeah, with those guys sitting there saying, oh, we used to play back in our day.
Let's hope that the boss of those lads up on the terrace there watching on with their free tickets isn't watching this game. Here is Doak, there is Humphreys into the midfield. Kendall and met with a physical hit by Filippo Drago. He's a specimen, all right. I can't say the name Drago without thinking of Ivan Drago in the Rocky movies. Certainly has a bit of punch. The Filippo variant.
Just hang fire, there's a player down holding his head. Time off. Time off.
Sam Grove-White coming in. Just player safety, Sam
that
Illo.
Was drummed to Ireland. They were in possession when we called time off.
He's taken a bang on the head.
Yeah, just make sure fingers crossed he's okay, because as we said, down four of their front row, down four of their props. And great carry by Sam Illo, you know, former number eight at school. He's dynamic, he's powerful.
Ireland scrummed, they were in possession. 2 minutes, thanks.
I think he just catches his face on the chin. One of those Italian defenders.
It was the secondary tackler, wasn't it? It just sort of changed his angle and his the collision was taken there. But that man, as you mentioned, Sam Illo, the old Wesley Club Leinster, he's very highly rated in Leinster. He's impressed in his performances so far and one of the six try scorers against Scotland in round one.
Yeah.
Good to see him back on his feet.
Cool. So there's no foul play there at all, thanks mate. He's checked, so there was no, the initial tackle was fine, it's just an accidental clash. There's no foul play, Tiemo's checked. Hasn't fine yet.
You gonna come off for an HIA though, Mike?
Yeah.
Sorry, head.
Yeah. So it's good to see him being looked after and coming off. But you know, for me it's pretty amazing that he played number eight throughout school and you know, he's learned
awesome. No foul play.
That scrummaging technique Ireland in such a short space of time and he's doing an incredible job.
You hear of time back on, rowers Ireland converting scrum. to hooker,
good
but
balance.
Probably less so tight head prop. He's built for it, isn't he, though? He's a big, powerful carrier and powerful scrummager in there as well. Probably no better man in the game than Tadhg Furlong for him to learn from at Leinster either.
That's fine. Let's get it right. Same scrum.
Yeah, exactly. A real role model for these young guys coming through. Obviously, Tadhg Furlong coming through the club system as opposed to the more traditional schools route system. And Sean O'Brien coming through the club system as well. So great to see quality players coming from both routes.
So last 90 seconds of this really fantastic first half. Can Ireland bounce back and get a score? It's knocked on at the base there. The Irish scrum under pressure. Nathan Doak went to clear the decks, but it's gone forward, and it's perhaps a one-off incident to sum up the first half for Ireland. They maybe don't look to have dusted themselves down from that English defeat the way that Richie Murphy would have liked, Mike.
Yeah, and it was such a physical encounter that last game against England. You know, they really emptied the tank there, and there were some bruised, battered bodies. You know, a short turnaround coming into this, and you know, their set piece hasn't fired in this first half. Discipline's been pretty poor, and you can see the energy there from the Italian team. They're high-fiving each other. I mean, I've got GCSE Italian, and I can hear them screaming, roaring Indiamo, which I think means let's go, is that right, Rory?
Pass.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I think your GCSE Italian is probably more Italian than I have
please.
In my locker.
Let's scrum.
Sorry, I'm actually telling a lie. It was French GCSE, not Italian.
Can we scrum more off, please?
Apologies.
That's an altogether different language.
Time up.
I was impressed for a moment.
Good setup.
Should have kept quiet, shouldn't I?
Are you suggesting scrum. That they're speaking scrum. French out there? Is it?
Italy scrum. Oh, Ireland knock on in the back. Italy scrum.
Oh, there we go. This could well be the last play. 30 seconds of this first half to go.
Crouch.
Five tries so far. Three to the Italy.
Set.
Two to Ireland. And it's Manfredi Albanese with the put-in. Rock solid Italian scrum. Staying in the drive. Lorenzo Cannoni with some footballing advantage. Skills at the base. Advantage now for Italy. There is Cannoni. Picks up. He's lassoed by Doak. Albanese is on here down the left channel. Good left-footed step. Double fend by Tommaso Menoncello. He's only 18 years old. My goodness, they make them different down in Benetton. Coming back
Nothing
for the advantage.
Under pressure, Ireland.
Clear instruction from Sam Grove-White.
Not staying straight.
And you get the sense Italy sense blood here. You know, another big scalp they're looking to take here. Coming so close against France. They were very unlucky in that game. And then obviously the performance last week against Scotland. But
1 metre off the line, fellas, please.
Totally getting on top in the scrum here, that set piece. Scrummaging as one, as we said before.
Yeah.
So, as it is, Leonardo Marin has pointed at the sticks. He's managed to nick himself a cheeky metre from where the initial penalty was given.
Let's go, please, 10.
He's told to get on with it, but we saw with his touchline conversion of his own try that he is capable. He can certainly strike a ball, all right. There are 2 from 4 this afternoon. Difficult to judge exactly what the wind is doing. Alex Kendallin questioning the position of the penalty. It's a final kick of this half for Leonardo Marin. The bones of 50 metres at Cardiff Arms Park. Oh, he's got plenty on it. It's straight through the middle. Luca Rizzioli, the loose head prop. High fives, punches the air. But that man there, Leonardo Marin, sees the ball floating through the sticks. Italy, well deserved, you'd say. Lead at half time, 23 points to 12.
Wait. Same ball. Wait. Same ball. Wait. New advantage, offside, onside, on, up, hands up. Still advantage. Still advantage.
Plenty on it. Adi Mahi.
Straight through the middle.
3 points arall.
Sir.
Adi Mahi.
Straight through the middle.
3 points arall.
Look at Rizzioli, the loose head prop.
Ar ddiwedd yr hanner cynta.
High fives. Punches the air. Mae'r sgôr ar Leonardo Marin.
Ydy yr Eidal.
Welcome back to Cardiff Arms Park, here in the Welsh capital, bathed in sunshine on this Wednesday afternoon, and the first match of three in the under-26 Nations Championship. Scotland and France will follow this one at 5 p.m. before the final act of today. Hosts Wales facing the unbeaten England. 8 p.m. kickoff for that one. Nothing else to do this evening, is there? Under 26 Nations Championship. Ireland back out on field, and by the looks of things, a change being made. Ben Moxham, that man in picture, made his way straight over to that right wing. And Ireland with work to do. They trail 23 points to 12, three tries, a conversion and two penalties for the Azzurrini. Gives them a strong position at half time. Ireland, that yellow for Jude Puthelwaite. Two tries of their own. De Butler and Saunderson, two of the three front rowers. Good to see that man, Sam Illo, back on his feet.
Keep them on side.
Alongside me, Rory Lawson in the commentary box this afternoon, Mike McCarthy. And it is Leonardo Marin to get us underway in the second 40. Driving the ball deep into the Ireland half.
Yeah, inside.
And it's Alex Kendallin.
Use it.
Who gathers the Irish captain, of course. The rock at the heart of the back row, but wearing number 7 this afternoon rather than number 8. And Mike, take us into the dressing rooms at halftime. What are the messages from the two coaching teams to their players?
Yeah, I think from Ireland's point of view, probably a few harsh words. You know, it all starts with a set piece. They've got to get that set piece parity, you know, because without that, it's impossible to play with that flair that we saw Ireland playing in rounds 1 and 2. So they've got to sort their scrum out. You know, it can be a long old day if they're, you know, they're not winning their own scrum. And they've got to not give the ball away too cheaply. You know, every time they've had the ball, they've given it away too cheaply.
Marin with the show and go. Try score in that first half, of course. Vincent round the corner. Little stab through, but well covered by Jamie Osborne. All the experience in the world, the Leinsterman. Close to 10 games for the champion Leinster side. Very highly rated in the province. But Italy over the top of the ball in that breakdown.
First arriving
and
player,
I think once again it's Lorenzo Cannone winning his side a penalty. And you mentioned it, Mike, discipline was a real problem for Ireland in the first half. That's the 8th penalty they've conceded in this match so far. Can ill afford to give away many more of them.
Yeah, but that penalty all started from an incredible tackle from number 12 for Italy, Filippo Drago. Real physical challenge. We spoke about how they like to get off the line, get up in the faces, yep, give the ball carrier as little time on the ball as possible. That's a great executed chop tackle.
Luca, down. Down.
For anybody who thinks you've got to tackle high to make an impact, there's a great example. Any youngsters watching? Filippo Drago, chop tackle at the knees. There's also a great example of a line-out steal by Mark Morrissey, and it's unleashed Alex Sirocca on the charge. It's flowing locks. There's another change there as well. I think Cahill Ford is on for Ireland with a left-footed clearance. He's hobbling a little bit off the back of it. I don't know if he's tweaked something in the backfield. And a swathe of Irishmen punched the air at that penalty win. And was it skipper Alex Kendallin?
That's right. Leading by example again, trying to raise the energy and bring the troops with him. As we said, he's had an incredible tournament. He just doesn't stop. He leads from the front with his actions. And a great line-out steal there from Mark Morrissey, getting up in the air. And that's the easiest way to defend them all is, you know, steal the ball, get up. Obviously done his homework during the week to see where they throw to. Really well read, good lift, up in the air, wins the ball back. You know, these positives followed by another positive there with the captain, Alex Kendallin, turning the ball over and look at the field position now. Really important they exert some pressure here and come away with some points.
Well, you say it, Mike, they're now 70 metres from that defensive line-out, and it's Sirocca who initially charged out from that line-out steal. Doke to Kendallin, line speed coming on from Nicola Piantella. Doke again, De Butler. Try scoring in that first half from the mall. Doke. This time it's Morrissey. Doke again. Little show and go carry by Cahill Ford, the Connacht man. Doke to Sirocco, to Okeke. Ireland setting up camp inside the Italy 22. Struggled to keep a hold of possession in that first half. Outside break by Kendall, and again the chop tackle comes in. Beautiful offload. Ford, half away, initially dragged down. Kendallin gets the ball away beautifully to Harry Sheridan. Sheridan for the line. Again, a shot to nothing. De Butler is there to gobble up the crumbs. Kendallin, the skipper, third time in this attack. Doak looks up, dives to the line. Can Doak get there? No, he's held out by De Bartolomeo. De Butler. Ireland within a foot. Has Sirocco got over? Not on this occasion. Kendallin again. Kendallin reaches out. Kendallin is over. But no, the penalty, the try has been given. I thought for a moment there that Sam Grove-White had given a penalty to Italy. But it's that man in the picture. Alex Kendallin tries versus Scotland and Wales in the opening two rounds. He has his third here this afternoon. And Ireland give Richie Murphy exactly what he would have looked for with regards to a reaction. They're back in the game.
Yeah, and we said really important they start this half well and come away with something when they've got this opportunity, this field position, and great continuity. They're keeping the ball 14 phases and the skipper leading from the front. Alex Kendallin getting in and giving Ireland that lift for a perfect start for the second half. But you know, what does that come from? It comes from that set piece parity. They had them all, they got that go forward, and it all stems from there.
Doak, you hear the cheers from the crowd on that far side. Splits the upright from the right touchline, right footer. There's the score by Kendallin, the skipper. The Munsterman is over. And that is a healthier looking scoreboard now.
Exactly. In that period, they just backed up a positive with a positive and another positive and onwards and onwards. We didn't have that in the first half. With Morrissey's line-out steal, Kindland's turnover, field position, more. Great work by Ireland.
So a four-point game. That man, Kendallin, so prominent within that, the swathe of attacks that came from the men in green. Shifting momentum at the start of this second half. Tangible, Mike.
Yeah, big time. It's really clear. I mean, the energy they've come out with in this second half, they're bouncing it. They looked a bit, little bit flat, a little bit lethargic. Weren't winning the collisions in that first half. And certainly, early days still. Only 7.5 minutes gone, but signs are very good for Ireland here. They've got that bounce, they've got that energy, the body language looks good, and certainly a bit of a shift in momentum.
Some fresh legs off the bench as well. Ruben Crothers is on for Daniel Okeke. And this time it's ill discipline from the Azzurrini. Doak, little chip over the top, sees the space in behind. Cahill Ford was after it. Couldn't gather it. It was the right idea. It was a free hit for Ireland. Didn't bounce to Ford on that occasion, but the Maul again generating some returns.
Yeah, I think Italy can feel a little bit aggrieved by that penalty. They've been done for pulling the Maul down, sacking the Maul. So as that jumper's feet touch the floor, you've got a split second to rip the ball winner to the floor. If it's anything after, you know, a second, you get pinged. But a lovely chip over the top.
Mark here. More discipline.
Clearly an area that Ireland have identified as space that the Italian press defence creates in behind. They tried the chip on two or three occasions in the first half. None of them as dangerous as that one. Two of them, in fact, charged down by Italy, but a theme that is continuing. That one was a free hit, of course, but this time De Butler can't hit his man. Italy have it. A little bit of footwork there from Giacomo Ferrari. Gets Sirocco out the way.
All forward, stay.
Marin.
Stay, three.
That's an enormous hoof of the ball. 60 metres downfield, Cannoni's on the chase, but this man is incredibly dangerous. Jamie Osborne, big rangy runner, two tries already in the championship for Osborne. Puthelwaite into that 15 metre channel. Forward, little show and go, but he's chopped by the enormous man Jon Nicolai, the tight head prop. Doak forward along the hands, left foot, Jamie Osborne, space in behind. Three men bearing down on Lorenzo Pani, give him no space to move.
Use it!
And Freddie Albanese totes it, use it, and given a little nudge by Sam Grove White there. He was warned in the first half. Doak, footwork gets him away from Flavio Vaccari. First touch for Ruben Carruthers, playing scrum half in place of Doak. There's Doak back in place. Osborne out the back, hands, Carson.
Leave it, you're off feet.
Carruthers again, drew the defender onto him. Lovely handling. Sam Illo driving Ireland into the 22 advantage, penalty advantage being played. Nathan Doak digs. It's going to come to nothing. Oh, Sam Grove White's going to bring the yellow card out here.
Six never sporting body weight.
And it's the skipper, Luca Andriani, in the blue headgear. The blue headgear no longer on as he heads for 10 minutes in the bin, but.
Shot called.
Sam Grove White, no hesitation at all, going for his yellow card there.
Yeah, certainly been a huge shift in momentum in this second half. Ireland have come out with a real urgency. I'm not sure what was said at half time in the change rooms, but you know, knowing Richie Murphy and the likes of Dennis Leamy in there, they set incredibly high standards. And the difference, they've come out with the energy, the passion, they've become real collision winners. Sam Illo there, running incredibly hard, getting over the gain line. And Italy can't cope with that pressure that Ireland are building. Great footwork for a big man. I mentioned, used to play number eight at school, but that's great feet for a big, heavy man. Leg drive, those yards after contact, and just shows when Ireland keep the ball and this expansive game we saw in rounds one and two, they're incredibly dangerous. But it relies on a set-piece platform. It relies on having good discipline and certainly exerting themselves in this second half.
Taking the opportunity to get a selfie or two in while we have the break in action.
We've taken our selfie, haven't we?
You did. You are down with the kids, Mike.
Time on. Back 10,
can be
please.
Seen on your social media channel, multiple social media channels for your followers.
Influencer.
Indeed, hashtag influencer. So it's Nathan Doak. Looking to turn this into a one-point game. This is his easiest nudge of the afternoon, and it makes no mistake. Clean strike, splits the posts. And we have a cracking 30 minutes in store of this opening match of round four of the under 26 nations. A 1 point game. Italy down to 14. Owen de Butler's afternoon is done. Ronan Loughnan is on, the Leinsterman. Alex Kendallin,
inside.
He is a pillar for this Irish side,
nine,
isn't he?
Use it.
Yeah, the amount of work he gets through is phenomenal. Same last week, Soroka as well. Serious engines on them, they just keep going and keep going.
And of course, both of those names have enjoyed top level experience. Kendallin from Munster, Soroka for Leinster.
Line will be green.
And it's really coming through in their performances this afternoon.
Yeah, exactly. And with Alex Kendallin, you know, he knows obviously that at Munster, club legend CJ Stander has finished up, and there's a real opportunity to stake that claim for that number eight position, which he's certainly done this tournament.
So Italy themselves looking to stake the claim. Here's Albanese, he sees his face down the blind side. Did very similar against Scotland in the last round. Try score on that occasion, player of the match as well. Vincent with the carry, 14 men Italy. Ferrari does well to win inside a penalty. Albanese has had enough of this, looking to up the tempo. Ireland deemed to have retreated the 10 metres they needed to from the penalty. Albanese. Marin, lovely direct line from Drago. Albanese again. Here's the man that won aside the penalty. Nice footwork again by Giacomo Ferrari. Albanese talking of footwork. Small man. See Mark Morrissey in front of him. Morrissey did well though, the big lock.
No, he's trapped. Ball's there. He's trapped. He fell on top.
Tommaso Menoncelli's gone down with what I hope is just cramp, but he's hit the deck hard. But it's play on for Italy. Drago again enveloped by this Irish defence. There's Marin to Jay-Z, whose try seems a long, long time ago now. Marin again. Drago. Welcome to the game, Ronan Loughnan. Marin, oh, there's the line speed. Jude Puthelwaite.
Use it!
What a tackle that was. Tommaso Menoncelli rocked backwards. In fact, it was Lorenzo Pani.
Stop the man on his feet getting the ball.
Italy defence, yeah, yeah. You could question it in the first half, Mike. But we've seen the reaction. Doak's away. Doak has seen space in front of him. Opportunistic. Tap and go. He's nudged the ball through. Che Mullins is after it. Che Mullins can't get his hands to it. It's a huge net gain for Ireland. Ireland, yeah. Italy almost caught napping there. Really quick thinking by Nathan Doak.
Yeah, great work by Nathan Doak. Really trying to inject pace and speed into this game. See a lot of the Italians down on the floor now. Starting to feel it, the lungs are burning. And Nathan Doak, knowing Italy have a man in the bin, really trying to lift up the speed of the game and the pace. But take a bow, Jude Puthelwaite. What a hit that was before. Setting the tone for this second half. Read it perfectly. Slightly too high in the first half with that tackle. And this, the quick thinking from Doak. Caught me by surprise as well. And unfortunately just can't quite control it here. Possibly held back there, actually.
I think Ian Tempest, the TMO, is going to have a look at this. I think it's actually Flavio Vaccari. It is. Flavio Vaccari, there you go, in the number 14 jersey. Just reaching out for Che Mullins.
Still got a player down. We've still got a player down, but yeah.
Early tackle.
That's okay.
There's definitely contact. I'm not sure whether it affects him collecting that ball, possibly with that right hand.
I'm trying to find Sam Grove. Oh, there he is. He's across seeing some of the players. I think he's being fed a bit of information from Ian Tempest. But he's not seeing these pictures just yet. He's with the Italian player getting some attention.
Good to play on it.
What are your thoughts on that one, Mike?
Yeah, well, there's definitely contact. His right arm gets held back.
Damn it.
Mate, there is early contact on him. I'm not sure he's going to regather the ball, so for me it'd be a penalty only. There is cover coming across. I don't know if you want to have a look at
so
yourself.
So we're just going penalty only for the early contact.
There is.
The
I can't be sure he's going to gather the ball, yeah. And it's definitely no more. So
just Italy playing the man without the ball, so it's just a penalty. Is that right?
And it's very marginal, mate.
Thanks,
yeah,
mate. Perfect. So, captain? We've had a TMO check, we've had an early tackle there. It's just a penalty only, okay? Thank you. No, it's not clear when he's going to regather the ball, but he has been taken early.
Yeah, definitely right decision. Che Mullins, as we said, his right arm was held back, but I don't think it would have affected him in terms of collecting that ball as it was so far over to the left. But I'm sure the Italians are glad of the rest there. They looked on their knees.
Step off.
But a great position here for Ireland. They've got to certainly take this opportunity.
So it's Loughnan to Sirocca.
Mall.
Italy look to hold it out, but Sirocco's... Is that Loughnan over? It looks like it's actually the skipper, Kendellin. It is. Kendellin has his second try of the afternoon. Ireland are making the most of this purple patch, and they have taken the lead for the first time in some time, and it's that man, the skipper, Ken Dellin, the beneficiary of a killer punch from the Irish Mall.
Lovely work line out, great take by Soroka. He's the ball winner in so many of these Mauls, and great go forward. They got the momentum going really early, all pushing together in low positions, going forward. And that man, it's that man again, Alex Ken Dellin, leading from the front. What an impact he's had in this second half. He's bringing the team with him, bringing those energy levels, bringing that physicality, and everyone's following him.
So that's a try bonus point now secured for Ireland. If they do win this, they will really build pressure. Can Nathan Doak add the two? Kick chase from Italy, just drifted in the breeze. Couldn't add the two. But Ireland, in this third quarter, really have shifted the dial, moved up through the gears. And Mike, is there potentially, we've seen this impact from the Irish bench, they're now in round four of this championship. We've spoken about the compressed nature of the championship. Italy only made one change coming into this game. It's taken Ireland to start gelling, but legs starting to tire perhaps.
Yeah, I think, and perhaps a little bit of hangover from that England game, and you know, perhaps they didn't quite turn up in the right frame of mind at the start of this game, and it's taken, you know, that a poor first half and a good talking to at half-time by the coaches, and the difference they've come out with, you know, everything they're doing, whether it's the carry, the tackle, the collisions, they've turned into collision winners, which they weren't in that first half.
So Italy now have to react, you would say. After Nathan Doak's quick tap penalty, there were five players down, absolutely knackered. Didn't look like any of them were actually injured. That time Jamie Osborne lost sight, I think, of that in flight. Couldn't gather it, but Ireland did well to pick up the scraps. Italy's discipline starting to waver a little bit as the pressure comes on. That's the 12th penalty that Italy have conceded so far in this match. There's been a real shift.
It's certainly been a costly yellow card for Italy.
Nine blue. Just wait and I'll get him on and we'll go.
So another change coming, this time for Italy.
Three as well, please. Three.
That man's had a lively afternoon, Manfredi Albanese, but his day is done. Alessandro Garbisi, that man in shot. Brother of course, Paolo Garbisi, who pulled the strings for the Azzurrini as recently as 2019. One of a number of the young players to have already taken that jump to the senior squad in recent years. None more rapid than Garbisi, Stephen Varney and Jacopo Trulla. Meteoric rise.
Scrum advantage not
could work. We yet see not a Garbisi combination in that senior Azzurri side in the years to come? Who knows?
I was a little surprised there. They've taken off Manfredi Albanese at nine. I thought he was having a fantastic game. You know, we saw his box kicking and releasing that pressure, but also for a small guy, he reminds me a lot of Dupont, the French nine. You know, for the size he is, he's very strong and physical and a real live wire, testing those front five around the breakdown when he's running and attacking with the ball.
That's about as big a compliment as you could give any scrum half in world rugby right now. There's the table as it stands. Ireland will leapfrog England if this score stays as it is. Bonus point, of course, secured. England are here later this evening to play against the hosts.
Bind.
Three wins from three, all with bonus points for England.
So both teams, I went straight head on head there, okay? You really need to keep your gap. First half was good, don't change that.
Same Ireland, stuff. A championship to defend.
No,
of course, the 2020 under-26 nations didn't reach a completion like so many sports impacted by the global pandemic. It's so good to see these youngsters out charging around. Many of them haven't played representative rugby since school. And they're now 19 or 20 years old. There are a couple of 18-year-olds in there, of course. making us guys feel particularly old. Italy, scrum dominance in that first half. Do so again, and Marine knows that penalty advantage is coming. Jamie Osborne, safe as houses under it.
Thanks, mate.
But Sam Grove-White will come back for the penalty. And Mike, quarter of the game still to go. You'd have to say at the moment, Ireland in control. But we've seen this Italian side, no shortage of ability or fight.
Yeah, exactly. And it's taken 20 minutes of this second half for Italy to go through a kind of a positive period. And like we saw in the first half, they were on top in the scrum. And again, it's on top there in the scrum as well. You know, for Ireland, not scrummaging with flat backs, rounded backs, and the pressure eventually telling for Italy, and a real opportunity here for them with them all.
And there's the skipper. They have, of course, been down to 14. Ireland have made them pay, but Luca Andriani is now charging into this line-out.
Sorry, yellow card's gone back. Time on.
Imposing back rower really does lead by example, albeit punished for cynical play. But here we go.
Out.
Italy scored one in the first half.
Don't change five. Once.
Seemingly under control is Matteo Baldelli. The hooker, replacement hooker off the bench. Sirocco climbing all over him. He's over the top of the ball, and those screams come from one side only, and it's the Irishman rewarded for that maul defence. Sirocco, you can't miss him, can you? Big lump with that, those flowing locks, all of the work done there, and wins his side a crucial scrum.
Yeah, I'm sure that was one of the key messages at half-time as well, you know, about how they defend that maul. First half, they weren't very Ireland weren't very aggressive. They didn't show too much venom in hitting it and knocking it back towards the touchline, but much improved there. Hit it really early, committing numbers, driving it back, and Alex Sirocco, he's a pest, he's a nuisance, and gets in there, gets his mitts on the ball, doesn't let go, and a really important turnover.
Job only part done, you'd say. Scrum has been under pressure, but this time it's the Irish put in, and it's the experienced head of Nathan Doak. You do see the squeeze come on. Two of that Irish front row, but speaking of experience, Kendallin, the breakaway.
Yeah, knock on into touch.
He slams the ground, knowing that he maybe tried to force an offload there that was definitely on, but couldn't execute it.
Yeah, when you're scrummaging there, you want to have 16 feet on the floor. Obviously, Italy looking to see when the Irish hooker moves his foot to tap the ball back. As soon as he takes that foot, one foot off the floor, that's their time to, they'll have a call to drive forwards and put Ireland under pressure. And that's what we saw there. They managed to get the ball out in a great carry.
Skipper on skipper.
By the skipper.
Yeah, Kendallin reintroducing, welcoming Luca Andriani back to the fray.
Straight round, that's an issue, but for me it was first forward and then it went round the corner.
Look how far into the scrum Kendallin has to reach to be able to clear the decks and get the ball in and away from that scrum.
I think three's getting subbed, are you? Are you staying on? So has he gone off?
Jack Boyle is primed, the 18-year-old. Loosehead prop is making his way on for George Saunderson, of course, try scorer in the first half, Saunderson. But it's Jack Boyle, the Leinsterman.
Time on, scrum.
Debut versus Scotland in round one.
Hold the weight.
There he is. What chances of that tape protecting a cauliflower ear for that young man, Mike?
Yeah, absolutely none, to be honest. The worst is when you're playing on sandy pitches in the rain.
Oh, this pitch is artificial, but it's consistent at least for these sides.
Use.
Again, here we go, Cannoni. We saw him in the first half. This time, tackle made by Cahill Ford, but Italy have momentum. Look at that counter ruck again. That was legal by Soroka. But as the tackler not rolling the first offence. This is a big moment in the game, Mike. Italy, first real meaningful pressure that they're building on Ireland.
Shot called.
Yeah, and we spoke about Ireland's discipline in that England game. The number of penalties they gave away, incredible amount. And yeah, that's just a needless penalty to give away, lying on the wrong side. It doesn't matter if it's an accident that you've got there, you just can't be there. You just have to make sure you're not in the way of producing fast ball for the attacking side. Got to be on your front, crawling out, and waving your hands in the air. Means nothing to the referee.
It was wise from Ross Vincent, the open side of Italy there, didn't he? The right leg, he just kept in the ruck and actually pinned down Cahill Ford. So he couldn't roll away. You're told obviously to roll east-west, but that leg of Vincent giving Leonardo Marin this opportunity. 3 from 5. Missed his first couple of kicks, but since has been perfect off the tee. And this one won't give them the lead, but it'll certainly turn it into that one-point game. Latest fly half to follow in the footsteps of Rizzi and Garbisi. Marine, oh, he's pulled that, has he? He has, he's snatched at it. You're not able to lip read with your GCSE French there, Mike, but I'd say he'd be disappointed with that one.
Definitely, big opportunity, but going back to that ruck where the player was pinned in at the breakdown. Good work by Vince in the dark arts, I think you were referring to, but you've just got to get out of there, and you've got to get onto your front and almost army crawl out of there, and he's stuck on your back in that turtled position. It's very difficult.
Pani does brilliantly, the fullback. He's been kept quiet by Ireland so far this afternoon, but they must keep an eye on him. Here's Garbisi to Marin. Marin, we saw his danger with ball in hand. Beautiful offload to Cannoni.
It's out.
There's no scrum half. Ball being called out.
Ball was out.
And it's Sam Illo who dives onto it. It's on for Ireland down the right-hand flank here. Here's Doak. Give and take. It's 2-on-2 down the right-hand channel. Osborne loses his feet. Cannoni's over that. Cannoni's on it. And Cannoni wins his side a penalty. The opportunity was there for Ireland. The back row man, the number 8.
You got cleared out.
What a crucial penalty for his side.
I didn't see a clear left, I just saw it cleared out.
Ireland looking very dangerous there. Great work from Sam Illo, identifying the ball was out of the ruck and getting down on it. Great hands down through the back line.
Yeah, for me, you got the left.
Drawing in the man, giving the pass.
Really tough to say exactly what the wind's doing here up in the gantry. We're seeing
time off.
Lovely stuff. Look at this offload from Marin. He's shown a full box of tricks so far this afternoon.
He's walking off, yeah.
Looks like Lorenzo Pani's afternoon is done.
Time's off, we'll put it on when they're in.
Fabio Schiavel is on. He is tough to miss. He is a big human being.
And Ireland just need to be careful. They're coming up together as one in that defensive line. You see there, Soroka a little slightly ahead, creating a dog leg. That's where the gap was for the opportunity.
There's Schiavel. Straight into the action. Gets the gain line. Quick ball round the corner. Big collision by Hassa. Garbisi. Marin can't get it, but here's Cannoni. The penalty winner. Italy look to find some tempo in their attack and accuracy. Oh, but just a little bit isolated there was Baldelli.
Oh,
he's done well to get the ball back.
Ireland goes forward.
And Ireland winning that ruck, just winning the inches.
He's letting the ball, he won the ball.
Soroka again, the man making a nuisance of himself and a crucial scrum win for the Irish side. You have the narrowest of leads coming into the final 10 minutes of this match.
time off.
Mike, by the looks of things, there are restrictions with regards to people who are allowed on the pitch. Water carriers, I think, are only allowed on when called on. But what are the key messages going to be going into each of the sides now? We saw the half-time reaction of Ireland. We've seen a counter-punch by Italy.
Right, water off, fellas. No
but these are crucial 10
Ireland.
Minutes, the championship
water
minutes
off,
that are going to dictate the finishing positions of both these sides.
Yeah, these are important times to get on crucial messages. So for Ireland, I think it'll be, you know, stick to the discipline. Don't give them easy access to your part of the field. But also in attack, keep hold of the ball. Continuity, respect the ball, look after it, build phases. When you build phases, that's when teams start to get defensively get tired, gaps start to appear, defensive teams start to give penalties away. And for Italy, I think a key message they'll be getting there is arrival of the two clearers of the breakdown to the ball carrier. There, that penalty came from the ball carrier carrying, and the arriving player's been a little bit too slow and a little bit too late, allowing Ireland to get in and over the ball.
Set. Hold. Get up.
Kendall into Doak. Clarity of mission there, getting the exit in. Kick's not gone necessarily where Menoncello would have liked it. Menoncello's gone to fullback now with the addition of Fabio Schiabel to the fray. Soroka, second touch, sticks it on the right foot. Is there anything this guy Soroka can't do? Garbisi goes back, chased by Cahill Ford. Here's Marin, looks up and thinks about the long pass into the outside channel, but Ireland have numbers. Cannoni.
Use
tired
it.
Bodies out there. The intensity of this game has been evident throughout. Of course, 6-day turnaround between all of these matches. Garbisi questioning the work of our assistant referee, but lovely work from Cahill Ford, creating something out of nothing.
Soroka, he's got the full bag of tricks there. Offloading, chips ahead. Nice little chip ahead by Cahill. Ford as well, does well to just get enough on it to tap it back. But the bench... Bench really have to add that energy coming on now. Obviously allowed to use 8 of your 11 subs. 10 minutes to go, really important they come on. Not just physically add something energy-wise, but vocally as well. Bring the noise.
Some running repairs. Matteo Ferrarin is readying himself on the touchline. There he is.
Can't scrum with a leg like that.
Petrarca is his club. Looks like there's going to be a second change made as well.
Yeah, send them on.
Italy, only one change from their big win against Scotland coming into this one. Mirko Spagnolo was that one change. He's now on for Luca Rizzoli.
Lads. We're still making subs. I'll get the gap for Napoli time.
And Tommaso Menoncello also gives way. Mattia Ferrarin on a fullback. There he is in picture.
You come in.
Can Italy find something? Can they respond? Or can Ireland put this game to bed? It's messy in the line out, but falls to Ruben Carruthers. Doak. Big collision in that midfield. Four players involved.
Oh,
it was Loughnan on the carry. Here's Doak, he's got Soroka outside him. Right footed step, goes into Giacomo Ferrari. There's that man again, Kendallin. He has three lungs by the looks of things, he just keeps on going, doesn't he? Ever present throughout this championship.
Never supporting body weight. You're going past ball, you're never supporting
penalty
body weight.
Given Nathan Doak shapes as if he might go, but...
Going beyond ball, never supporting.
It's a big penalty, isn't it, Mike? Given the field position, the stage in the game, the scoreline, just simple possession looked after by Ireland. Penalty conceded by Italy. What will Ireland do here?
You must go on Bobby lifting, not off feet past.
Well, if they go for the three, they'll obviously take it to 7 points. But I think they'll kick to the corner, back them all. I've seen a good play they've used a number of times during this championship. A front peel around the front. But Ireland have shown every time in this half that they keep composed, keep the ball, respect the ball, look after it. Don't throw those 50-50s. They run hard, they run direct, they get over the gain line.
Four blue.
Italy start to give penalties away or gaps start to appear.
Well, given the injuries that Ireland came into this championship with, given the injuries they picked up, it would be all too easy to look for excuses that the depth maybe isn't there or lack of rugby, but the reaction we've seen in this second 40 in particular, 23-12 down at half-time, Italy scoreless in this second half. Only that one chance to Leonardo Marin in the second half, and Ireland looked to put the game to bed. The maul once again built.
He's always in.
Wonderful response by the Azzurrini, though. They look to have halted it. They certainly have. Kendellen is over it. Doak into that midfield to Ben Carson. Big afternoon from the for the Banbridge man. Good clear out over the top of the ball. Here's Kendellen inside to Pothelwaite. Kendellen like an energizer bunny. Nice footwork from Harry Sheridan. Penalty though goes the Mirko Spagnola. Mirko Spagnola off the bench at loose head prop. And a crucial intervention from the big man, winning his side a penalty. Earns five high fives from Lorenzo Cannoni.
Crucial work by Italy there at the breakdown. Ireland were going very well there. Some good, strong carries getting over the gain line. Here, Harry Sheridan pumping the legs, a good fend.
He's marked up.
The number 17, Mirko Spagnola, does incredibly well to get over the ball and ride the clear out.
The immovable object, Spagnolo. 5+1 line out here for Italy. It's a bit lower than I'm sure Matteo Baldelli was aiming, but they have the ball.
One stop.
Penalty advantage.
17 entry.
That's a soft penalty,
17,
isn't it? Mike, that's
one in whereby, the
given the position 17. In the game, the position on field, it just gives the Azzurrini the opportunity to clear their lines.
Can I just come around the side?
Yeah, and I think we sometimes you're a little bit eager when you haven't played that much or been involved in the starting team that much, and yeah, a little bit
Ireland
eager there,
come.
Giving the penalty away. But I think for Italy, this second half, it's been a case of they had that lead going into half time, and sometimes we've been in positions there before, Rory. You come out in the second half and you almost stop playing. You think the job's kind of pretty much done. And it's, from Italy's point of view, they had to come out of the blocks like they started that first half, and they just haven't done that.
They're still in the fight, though. Let's make no bones about it.
Beyond 15.
And there's the skipper, Andriani, round the corner. It's clean ball. Garbisi. Garbisi again. Marin.
Stop 12!
Looks to it's a kick to nothing.
12 in front.
Oh, and to compound the error, Drago, the number 12, was in front of the kicker, was told to stop. Oh, and it's the softest of penalties conceded by Italy.
Yeah, we'll play.
Andriani, the skipper, is hobbling. I think it's Nekulai is down receiving a bit of treatment.
Time off. This guy here, is this set?
So it's Mohamed Hassa, down retrieving some treatment. Just towards the bottom of your screen there, well away from where the set piece was due to be taking place.
Replacing in Italy, number 20, Giovanni Sandinese, replacing number 6, Luca Andreani.
So here are all of the tries from this afternoon, Mike. 7 of them. We've been really in for a treat. Treated to some magnificent rugby.
It's been an absolute tri-fest. It's been a great game to watch. Italy starting that first half incredibly well.
Same as always, fellas.
Running at real pace. Pushing the offload. That back three causing Ireland a lot of problems. But Ireland showing great heart in the second half to fight back.
They certainly have. Ronan Loughnan hits his target.
First off.
The men at the front fighting hard. Morrissey and Sheridan. Ben Carson direct. Here's Doak. He really has pulled the strings in that number 9 jersey. Kendallin led from the front. Skipper, magnificent performance. Here's Puthelwaite. Canoni was over that, but just off his feet, couldn't compete.
Not on ball, no.
Clear communication from Sam Grove-White there. Cahill Ford. Ireland look to close this match out into that midfield again. Ben Carson, who started this all from the hit up off the line out. Doak to Illo, hands. Puthelwaite, that one doesn't go to hand, but as if you needed to ask who was going to be there, it's Soroka. Tell you what, I bet he eats everybody's leftovers at dinner
first
as well.
First defence is off feet to you. Italy off feet.
He is all action.
The ball down.
He is there to pick up the crumbs.
8 attacking past the ball.
And Cannoni this time penalised. Italy's discipline really has gone in this second half. 15 penalties conceded in total now. 30 in the
time
match,
off.
In fact. So it's been honours even. Neither of the sides, could you say, are squeaky clean.
Time is off. 2.5 minutes to go. Yes,
Mike, you're player of the match this afternoon.
8 off speed.
Alex Kendallin, the Ireland skipper, he's been all action, hasn't he?
Oh, he has been phenomenal. He started this fight back in that second half. The way he's gone about his work, leading from the front, the energy, the dynamism he's brought in the carry, 20 carries, 11 tackles. He has had a phenomenal game. And he's certainly my under-26 nations player of the match.
Well, he came into this match with 2 tries bagged in the championship. I'm not sure he'll have scored 2 more important tries than he has in this second half, upping his tally to 4 in the championship. That man, Soroka, can't have been far away though. Those 2 in the back row in particular have shone all afternoon.
Down by Green.
As Ireland look to put
down
this game
Green.
To bed, see it home. Again, it's the man in the midfield, Ben Carson, keeping it simple, Loughnan round the corner. Hands on the ball, but there is our player of the match, Alex Kendallin.
Hands off, Rock!
He will hope to have the player of the match and winning captain interview after this one.
Stripping it on the ground, 20.
And that could well be it.
Time off, captain.
Let's hear what Sam Grove-White has to say.
You captain? There's a lot of penalties at the breakdown. Your discipline needs to improve or someone else goes to the bin.
Lorenzo Cannone has taken over the captaincy from the penalty Luca Andreani.
Time is on. Time is on. Shot a goal.
So Ireland, the game point at the sticks. Okay. They know that the game will restart. But Nathan Doak has the minute
restart.
To go.
They've gone goal.
Let's just take a second or two to talk about Alex Kendallin. Mike, you mentioned he's been all court. He's been both sides of the ball, an absolute nuisance. Two tries, a really crucial component within this, what's looking like an Irish win.
The game will restart.
Just what you want your captain to do. He's led and everyone else has followed. The way he speaks to the players is one way, but he leads by his actions. And he's certainly brought that energy, a real physicality, a dynamism in his tackle, a real hunger and appetite for work and endeavour. He just doesn't stop. And you know, also worth mentioning his sidekick, Alex Soroka. I think he's had a fantastic game as well. And you know, he's played a lot of minutes in this competition as well. He's been at the heart of everything.
So Nathan Doak to extend the lead. He knew that the game would restart, but he wanted that ball to go right over the back of the stadium. And that should put the game to bed. We've seen already, Mike, that stranger things can happen within this championship. Italy will have the chance to restart. It's a seven-point game. Now, you'd have to say Italy definitely deserve a losing bonus point. The effort they've put into it, particularly in the first half, scoreless in this second half, perhaps just ran out of juice a little bit. It's Doak, receives the pass from Carson. Sam Grove-White, a shrill blow of the whistle. The job is done. Ireland in the opening part of this festival of rugby here in round four of the under-20s Six Nations Championship. They have done it. They've picked up all 5 points. They go to the top of the table until the next match. It's final score here at Cardiff Arms Park. Italy 23, Ireland 30. Mike, seven tries, over 50 points. It was a, you said it was a tri-fest. Italy really did pick up and carry on where they left off against Scotland. A fantastic first half of action, but you have to say, really impressive reaction from Ireland, of course, defending champions, and they're not done in this fight, are they?
No, certainly not. And it's a story of two halves. Italy came out 100 miles per hour like they did the previous round against Scotland. And it kind of looked like Ireland just didn't turn up. They were very slow out of the blocks. Italy are on top of everything. Set piece. You know, that pressure was telling Ireland we're giving penalties away. They're on the wrong side of the discipline. They looked a little bit lethargic, low in energy. Bit of a hangover maybe from that England game the week before. But whatever was said at half-time, you know, the coaches set incredibly high standards. They came out with a real energy, hunger, appetite, desire to work hard and outwork this Italian side. They started winning the collisions, their discipline got better, their set piece got better, and slowly they kept chipping away with positive incidents and clawed their way back and took control of the game. And it's a great fight back from that first half.
Well, it was 23-12 after 40 minutes. Those three first half tries by Italy, who fought incredibly hard. They pick up a losing bonus point, but that is all they have to show for it. For Ireland, it's the full 5 points. They overcame that half-time deficit. Two second-half tries by captain Alex Kendallin saw home the victory that they really came here looking for. Richie Murphy will be frustrated with the first half, delighted at the outcome of the match. And it was a fantastic second half reaction that saw them over the line. And we're going to now get down pitch side and hear from our player of the match.
George, congratulations. I'll let you do the honour and present Alex Kandelin, the winning captain and player of the match, with his award.
Cheers, Alex. Thanks, mate. Thank you.
Many congratulations to you, Alex. An exciting game to watch, but what was it like to play in it?
Yeah, geez, it was tough. We knew what Italy would bring. They bring their physicality up front and then that ability to whip it out the back when they needed to. It was a very nutritional game and, credit to Italy. They really put it up to us today.
You led by example and you all showed great character to battle back after a tough first 40. What was said at half-time?
Yeah, look, we knew we didn't come out in the first 40. Liam's, Cully and Richie brought us in at half-time and they told us to just stick to the process. Nothing changes. We knew Italy would start to fade away towards the end and we could capitalise on that, and I think we did very well.
As you said, credit to Italy for their part in an exciting game.
Yeah, look, it was. I was gassed after the first 5 minutes. They have some special players out there, and it was really fun to play.
A tough game next for you, facing France. What can you expect from them?
Yeah, look, we'll enjoy this win now. We'll take the day off, and we'll look into France and the last game. And look, we're looking forward to it.
Alex, many congratulations to you.
Cheers.
And to Ireland.
Thanks a million.
Yeah. Manfredi, commiserations. Is that a game we should have won?
Yeah, we did a very good first half. In the second half, we didn't play well in our pitch, and we know that Ireland play very well, so all the opportunity that he had, he scored.
It was quite a match, and despite the loss, you must be very pleased with the way you performed and played and the character you showed. Especially at the end when you battled.
Our identity was is the physicality, the defense, and second half we was a little bit more shy, so Ireland take all the opportunity.
You're facing the English next, a tough way to finish the tournament.
Yeah, it's the first team of the tournament. We know that it's a very tough game. We see that we can play with all the team, with Ireland, France, Wales, all one. So we are going to play the same way with England, and always we play for win.
Manfredi, good luck.
Thanks.
Against England.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye.